Hi, we're Mark and Shauna, and this is the Duck and Dive.
Step one, we're going to practice the duck and a prep for the dive. So Mark's going to go down, and as he goes down, he's going to bring me in here, and I'm just going to step on the 1 foot and practice getting on top of his back like this. So all together, we go duck, 1 foot up, and try to land on the back. And you'll see I'm really far forward here on his back.
Leaders, if you feel like you're having trouble getting her to stay on your back, it's probably because your back is curved too much. Try and straighten out your back so she has something flat to lay on. The important thing for leaders is to make sure that you have your feet nice and wide. If you have your feet close together, you're going to be a really unstable base.
Step two, we want to let the follow feel a little bit of what she'll experience when she does this dive and flip over. So we're just going to have the leader stand up while they're holding her leg so she can get a sense for what that feels like. So I'm going to go in here, Mark's going to catch my leg and just lift up. Step three, the leaders are going to pull the follow onto his back. He's got to provide some energy so I get far enough on his back when we're going into the aerial. So Mark's just going to give me a little pull so I can jump high. On to step four, the follows are now going to grab onto the leader's legs, and that's our last step before we go over. Follows, you're going to be making this shape with your hands, with the thumbs on the outside. When you're going in, you go over his back, and I'm going to aim for the inside of his thighs. So here we go, Mark gives me that little pull up. And then I aim for the inside, and my thumbs are on the outside of his thighs. So follows, you'll notice when we go in, we're going over the top and reaching for the inside. And then as we flip over, our arms end up on the outside of his thighs, and that's what lets us stay up. Step five, typically we ask that you use a spotter for this section. The spotter can actually flip the follow over so she doesn't have to use any of her own momentum for this, and that'll make it safer. So she can get to step four, let the spotter flip her over, and we're gonna skip over that part and just show you how we get over. Follows, I grip really tightly on the legs. That's really what's holding me up. I pull down on those as I flip over. Other than that, he gives me a good pull, and I have good momentum over. And you have to get some timing between those two things, between the pull and the flip over. Follows, make sure you keep your abs tight and your butt up when you land.
And leaders, we're gonna go over her shoulders with our arms, get in, into her armpits, and then kind of lean back and let her walk herself up out of the area. Okay, leaders, here's a fun variation that you can do instead of the arm lift at the end. So once she's down here holding herself up, you can actually lean to one side, get her to rest on this calf, and then set it over, extend the leg up, and then get out of it that way too.